I'm going to show you how to schedule a project in Excel. Someone asked me the other day whether it was possible to schedule a project similar to what they do in Microsoft Project, and I thought about it, and it certainly isn't a difficult thing. So I'm going to show you how I did it. I am not a home builder by any stretch of imagination, but I downloaded a list of activities that you need to complete to build a home, and that's one of the easiest projects I think that I can talk about because everybody has some idea about building a home. I have an abbreviation for each of the tasks, and I have put it in the B column here. And so I have grading going on first, and then I have foundation, and then I have framing. Each of these tasks in a different color code. Now, if the framers decided that they were going to be done before that, it's just a matter of simply deleting it, or if you wanted to extend the framers longer, you could click on the bottom and drag them off for a couple of or bring them, give them another couple of days in your schedule. It's as easy as that. I am down to roughed in electrical here, so let me scroll over here so we can see this. And this is going on in February, and I think, not that I know, but I think it when roughed in electrical is going on, you could do roughed in plumbing here. So what we're going to do is I'm going to hit my button and it'll bring up a user form. And so I'm going to say, so task abbreviation is plumbing roughed in. So it's P-L-U-R. So I'm going to enter that. Okay, and I'm going to start that. Let me look at this. So I would say that probably I could start that on Wednesday the 5th here. So it's going to be February. I'm going to select, and I'm going to do the start day of the 5th. And I don't know how long that takes. Let's give them Friday. Okay, and then I click the button, enter task. And the roughed in plumbing is going in here. So probably you need to have that done before you do your roughed in HVAC, which is the heating and air conditioning. So let's clear the form and let's have the heating and air conditioning start on February 10th, right? Because that's after the electrical and the plumbing are in. So let's go for the 10th. And so I'm going to go HVA and then R for roughed in. Okay, and then I'm going to start it on the 10th, on February 10th. And I'm going to give them, I don't know, give them to the 13th. And so I'm going to enter task. And so there's your air conditioning and heating being added in. Okay, so let's clear the form and let's close it. Let me show you the code. So basically I made a user form, and the user form, the only thing, so these are just text boxes, and the only thing that's different is this is a combo box, and if you drop it down, it's referring to, going back to my sheet, on sheet 2 I have January to December here, and I've named this range as months, and so my combo box is referring to, if we click on that and we go down to data source, source data, I think, row source, bring it up here, then it says months because that's my named range. Okay, so now let's look at the code, and I will of course include the code in the description of this video. So let's right click on here to look at the code. View code. Okay, so basically I've declared a few things. Name is string, range is range, row number, month number as integer, Lstart, Lend, difference. LNext is next as an integer. Okay, so now in the text box I'm saying, telling it which field. So enter name and then text box trim. Okay, then, so if they say January, I've only done it for 3 months, but I can certainly do it for the rest. Combo box, if it says January, then you move 2. And if combo box is February, then you move 33. And combo March, you move 62. Okay. And if the combo March value is less than 1, no month selected, and then you'll get an error message. Lstart, and so if you put the date in, so it's Lstart, so if you put the 10th in there, then it's going to add it to the month move that you've calculated up here. And then the same thing with the ending date, that's going to add it to the month move. And then it's selecting that in sheet one cells row number that you've picked by the name of the target, and the Lstart equals name, and sheet one row number, and LN is the same name. And then it's going to bring the name of the task all the way across, the abbreviation for the task. And so, and it loops around, and so you can keep, you can clear your form and then enter another task. So let's go back to the sheet here. So you can see that I have the task name here. So framing, I have frame, windows, I have wind all the way across. So you can see what the task name is. And if you can't remember what the color that you have selected for the conditional formatting. And so that's how I made a project plan in Excel. Please subscribe.